am here to explain your topic, very important topic from general pathology. I'm going to talk about cell death. We know cell deaths are of two types, apoptosis and necrosis. So in this particular lecture, I am going to talk about apoptosis, very, very important topic. And we know there are three processes in continuity. First, cell adaptation takes place, then cell injury, then cell death, whenever any cell is under stress. So this is the sequence, but I am going to talk about apoptosis in this particular lecture. So I am going to talk about cell death, the two types of cell death, apoptosis and necrosis. So I am going to talk about apoptosis today. So let's start apoptosis. So what is apoptosis? These are the headings under which I am going to discuss the topic. So what is apoptosis? What is the definition of apoptosis? So if you ask me in simple words, so particularly I will say in one word, apoptosis is cell suicide. Now why a cell do a suicide? No one wants to do a suicide now. Why a particular cell is doing suicide? Why? Why and how? So why it is doing suicide? So if there is any cell who has already performed its function, the cell has already performed its function and it is no more required in the body, the first situation. Or the second situation, the DNA of this cell is damaged due to physical, chemical or biological carcinogens. The DNA is damaged to such an extent that it cannot be repaired anymore. So in these two particular situations, either the cell is not required in the body, it has already performed its function, or the DNA of the cell is damaged to such an extent that it cannot be repaired anymore. In both of these situations, the cell will die by itself. That is, the cell will do suicide. So that is the answer of why. Why it is doing suicide. So in two conditions, it is doing suicide. Now the second question, how it is doing. So this is the definition of apoptosis given in Robbins, the big definition, you know. So let me simplify it. Let me simplify it. I will show you that slide again. Just understand the sketch diagram drawn by me. So can you see this is a cell? This is a cell. This is the nucleus of the cell. In the cytoplasm of the cell, various enzymes are present which are known as caspase. In all cells of our body, these caspases are present. But normally, these caspases are inactive. In cytoplasm, these are inactive. All of them are inactive. But whenever that cell is designated to die, it is destined to die. It is supposed to die. Either it has performed its function or its DNA is damaged. In both of these situations, this cell is designated to die now. Then in such situation, these caspases will become activated. How it will become activated? It will become activated by one of the two processes, either intrinsic pathway or by extrinsic pathway. I will explain you both pathways in detail. Just have patience. So either of the two pathways, these caspases will become activated. Once they will become activated, what they will do? After becoming activated, they will degrade the nucleus. The activated caspase in the cytoplasm will degrade the nucleus, as well as cytoplasmic proteins, as well as cell membrane of the cell. So everything is degraded by these caspases. This cell is converted into multiple small bodies. Multiple fragments of the nucleus and multiple fragments of the cytoplasm will enter in one, and multiple fragments of the cell membrane will enter in one body. So one body contains fragments of nucleus, fragments of cytoplasm and fragments of plasma membrane, and these bodies are known as apoptotic bodies. So ultimately these caspases are converting the cell into multiple small bodies known as apoptotic bodies. Ultimately a phagocyte will come and engulf all the apoptotic bodies. The phagocyte is coming and engulfing all the apoptotic bodies. So in short, there is no leakage outside. There is no leakage of cytoplasm outside, so there is no inflammation. No leakage, no inflammation. These are the hallmarks of apoptosis, which differentiate apoptosis from necrosis. Done. So can you see? Now read the definition. So it is a pathway of cell death. Yes or no? Apoptosis is a pathway of cell death in which it is tightly intracellularly regulated. Okay. In which a cell which is destined to die, it will activate certain enzymes known as caspases inside the cytoplasm. Those caspases will degrade the cell's own nucleus, as well as cytoplasm, as well as protein. Ultimately, multiple apoptotic bodies are formed. All of them undergo phagocytosis. There is no leakage, no inflammation. These are the hallmarks of apoptosis. Please learn it. So can I say apoptosis is a way of eliminating unwanted cells from the body? Yes, of course, you can say. So apoptosis occurs of a single cell, not a group of cells, as in contrast to necrosis, which occurs of a cluster of cells. Necrosis always occurs in groups. Apoptosis is a programmed cell death. It is genetically programmed and it is energy dependent. For apoptosis, we require ATP. सेल रिक्वायर इट भी, मरना भी मुफ्त में नहीं है, फ्री में नहीं है, मरने के लिए बिफोर डाइंग ऑल्सो सेल हैज टू इन्वेस्ट एनर्जी, सो दैट इज द थिंग. ओके एनीवेज, कमिंग ऑन द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ अपोप्टोसिस, एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू देयर आर टू पाथवेज, एक्सट्रिंसिक पाथवे एंड इंट्रिंसिक पाथवे. सो एक्सट्रिंसिक इज नोन एज एक्सट्रिंसिक बिकॉज हियर द सिग्नल, here the signal will signal for dying, cell will receive the signal now that it has to die. In extrinsic the signal will come from external, signal will come from external, I will tell you how. And in intrinsic the signal will come from inside the cell only, inside the cell only from DNA the signal will come, and cell will come to know that I have to die now. In both of these situations cell will do the suicide, cell will commit suicide. Done. Both of these path we have two phases, initiation phase, execution phase, initiation phase, execution phase. Now the beauty of this pathway, I will tell you everything, the beauty is that execution pathway of both execution phase of both pathways, intrinsic and extrinsic, is common. Intrinsic and extrinsic. So I will tell you a story, listen it like a story, a beautiful story. So first I will tell you initiation of extrinsic pathway, then I will tell you initiation of intrinsic pathway. I will leave both initiations at intermission. After intermission, the rest of the movie will be continued in execution pathway, which will be common for both. So I will tell you initiation of extrinsic first, initiation of intrinsic then execution of both of them. So listen this movie in three parts. So let me start the first part, extrinsic pathway. I am starting with the first one, extrinsic pathway ka initiation. Then intrinsic pathway का initiation, then execution दोनों का साथ में लेंगे because it is convergence and common in both. Let me start with the first. Now listen it like a story, very 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 important. Extrinsic pathway का initiation phase. As I have told you, extrinsic pathway को extrinsic इसलिए कहते हैं because here the signals come from external. External, that's why extrinsic. Listen, this is a cell. This can be any cell of the body from head to toe, human body. So these cells, on the surface of the cells, death receptors are present. Can you see the red colored receptors? These are death receptors. Death receptors. These are of two types. These are either, these are FAS also known as CD95. One and the same thing. CD95. And second is tumor necrotic factor, TNF receptor. So one of the death receptor is present on the surface and they are present at a distance from each other. Between two death receptors you can see certain distance is present. So normally it is normally present on all the body cells. Done. So let me draw a sketch diagram for it. Can you see a cell? Say yes or no. Yes, of course. You can see the nucleus, you can see the DNA, you can see the cell membrane. On the cell membrane, beautiful, you can see death receptors. So these death receptors, just suppose I'm considering the first death receptor, FAS, also known as CD95. It can be TNF alpha also. So when ligand will come, ligand is FAS for FAS and TNF for TNF. So FAS is coming, the yellow color here is the ligand. When ligand is coming and binding with the death receptor, it is giving the message to the cell, conveying the message that you have to die. So here signal is carried by the ligand, and ligand is coming from outside, external. That's why it is known as extrinsic pathway, because here the signal is carried by ligand and it is coming from outside, not inside the cell. So it is coming from outside. So can you see, let me zoom it out this portion. So I'm zooming it out. So can you see, this is FAS ligand. These are the death receptors. You can see these are present at a distance from each other, CD95 or FAS. When ligand will bind with the receptor, when this ligand is binding, this is the ligand binding with the receptor, then what will happen? Multiple receptors come closer to each other. Multiple death receptor comes closer with each other when this ligand is binding to the receptor, fast receptor. So these multiple fast receptors come closer, they become activated. And on the cytoplasmic side, when multiple of them are coming together, they will form a domain. They will form a domain. It is known as FAD, F-A-D-D, fast associated death domain, FADD, fast associated death domain. Now this is the cytoplasm of the cell, you can see inside it. When this FADD is formed in the cytoplasm, what will happen? This cytoplasm contains all caspase, caspase number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, many caspase, but all of them are inactivated. All of them inactivated. With the formation of this FADD, the first caspase to be activated is caspase number 8. So procaspase 8 will get converted into active caspase 8. So that is the story. So this FADD is converting procaspase 8 into active caspase 8. So these are the diagrams drawn by me, sketch diagram. These are the diagrams from Robbins, you can see. Can you see a cell membrane here? Can you see a death receptor here? When can you see a ligand here? when ligand is coming and binding with the death receptor, can you see multiple death receptors coming closer? Can you see formation of a domain? The domain formed here is known as death domain, fast associated death domain, because of which this pro-caspase 8 is getting converted into caspase 8. So what will happen next? You will ask, ma'am, what is the story ahead? This is the flowchart, you can read by your own. So when fast ligand is coming, it is binding with fast receptor, multiple fast receptor come closer, a domain is formed on the cytoplasmic side. It is known as fast associated death domain, and it will convert pro-caspase 8 into active caspase 8. So that was about fast. The same can happen with TNF also. Instead of fast, if TNF is present, then TNF ligand will come. Instead of fast ligand, TNF receptors, it will bind to the TNF receptors. And instead of FADD, TRADD, TRAD will form. That is TNF receptor associated death domain. Hai ye bhi death domain hi, but it is TNF receptor associated death domain. And again, it will convert the same caspase 8, pro-caspase 8 into active caspase 8. So story is same with both of them, either FAS or TNF. So where I am leaving, I am done with here. You will say, ma'am, what will happen again ahead? प्रो कैस्पेज 8 एक्टिव कैस्पेज 8 में कन्वर्ट होकर करेगा क्या? सेल डेथ तो ही नहीं, सेल सुसाइड तो अभी तक नहीं हुआ. आई विल कंटिन्यू द स्टोरी इन एग्जीक्यूशन फेज, जस्ट होल्ड इट ऑन, इंटरमिशन इज देयर, जस्ट लर्न द स्टोरी टिल इंटरमिशन. आई विल कंटिन्यू इट इन लेटर हाफ. लिसन, आई एम लीविंग द स्टोरी हियर एट कैस्पेज 8. आई विल कंटिन्यू इट फ्रॉम कैस्पेज 8 इन द एग्जीक्यूशन फेज, बट आफ्टरवर्ड्स लेट मी टेल यू इनिशिएशन फेज ऑफ इंट्रिंसिक पाथवे फर्स्ट. We have completed initiation phase of extrinsic pathway. Now I am covering initiation phase of intrinsic pathway. I will leave the story here and then I will continue both stories together in execution. Let me start intrinsic pathway initiation phase. I hope you people are understanding, enjoying it. So okay, intrinsic pathway initiation phase. Here it is known as intrinsic pathway because here the stimulus will come inside the cell, not from outside in the form of ligand. So here the stimulus will come from DNA damage. DNA damage. So listen, please, beautiful diagram. Can you see this is a cell? Everyone see this is a cell. Everyone see this is the nucleus of the cell and this is the DNA inside the nucleus. DNA is healthy, absolutely all right. And this is the mitochondria of the cell. The inner membrane of the mitochondria, the outer membrane of the mitochondria, between the two membranes a protein is present. It is known as cytochrome C. Cytochrome is the C is the protein present between two mitochondrial membranes in the space. It never comes out in the cytoplasm. If it comes out in the cytoplasm, now apoptosis will take place. So mitochondria has transit. The gate of the mitochondria is known as mitochondrial transit. This is the gate of the mitochondria. It is known as mitochondrial transit. So why you can ask me, ma'am, why the cytochrome C is not coming out of the gate? Who is preventing it? So there are two guards. There are two guards sitting there with a danda in their hand. Ki, no, cytochrome C, you just go inside. You cannot come outside in the cytoplasm. So these two guards, the name of these two proteins, these are two proteins, BCL2 and BCLX. So these are preventing apoptosis. These are preventing cytochrome C to come out. That's why these two guards are known as anti-apoptotic proteins. Anti-apoptotic proteins are there. So BCL2, BCLX and the third one is MCL. You can also learn the name of MCL. BCL2, BCLX and MCL. So these are the main anti-apoptotic proteins which are closing the door. So preventing cytochrome C to come out because DNA is absolutely all right. But once DNA damage is occurred, if it is beyond repair, first P53 will try to repair it. If P53 cannot repair it, it is beyond repair, it is too much damage. Then what will happen? This DNA will send a signal to the mitochondria that I am damaged, just kill the cell. I am damaged. This cell cannot survive anymore. I am damaged from inside and I cannot be repaired. So just initiate the process and start do the suicide of the cell. So this signal is received by the mitochondria. Now signal andar ki andar aa raha hai. Signal is sent from DNA to mitochondria. That's why it is known as intrinsic pathway. It is not the ligand coming from outside like the previous ones. It is intrinsic pathway. So signal is sent from the DNA to the mitochondria. So what will happen? Two guards were present, na? BCL2, BCLX, which were preventing cytochrome C to come out. These two guards are replaced by three another guards. So name of the three guards, Bax, Bak, Bim. One more you can add, Bad. Bax, Bad, Bim, Bad. So these are the guards which will open the door. So they will allow cytochrome C to come out and they will allow to apoptosis to happen. That's why these guards are known as pro-apoptotic proteins. Pro-apoptotic proteins. Have you got it? And BCL2, BCLX were anti-apoptotic. MCL, these were anti-apoptotic proteins. So when these guards will come, they will open the transit. So this cytochrome C will come out in the cytoplasm. See, so when these are replaced by these, open the door, cytochrome c will come in the cytoplasm. So what will happen when cytochrome c will come in the cytoplasm? In the cytoplasm again all caspase are present, caspase number 1 2 3 4 5, but all of them are inactivated. So caspase number 9, not 8. 8 was the first caspase to be activated in extrinsic pathway. We are talking about intrinsic pathway now. Here caspase number 9 is the first caspase which will be activated. So in the cytoplasm normally caspase 9 is inactive, that is procaspase 9, because it is binding with its best friend known as APAF1. What is the full form of APAF1? Apoptotic activating factor 1, APAF1. So this is pair. Always these are two best friends, APAF1 and procaspase 9. They always move together, together, together. And until and unless, please listen, until and unless this procaspase 9 is bound with APAF1, it will remain inactive only. So what will happen? The cytochrome C will come out in the cytoplasm and wo APAF1 ko pata ke chala jayega ki APAF1, you come with me, you just come with me, leave procaspase 9 and you just come with me. So there is a triplet, you know. So the cycle, isn't it like an interesting story, you know? Then only you will not forget it. So the cytochrome C is taking APAF1 with him. So this procaspase 9 will remain alone. So it will get activated. So it will get activated when cytochrome C take APAF1 with him. Procaspase 9 will become activated, convert into active caspase 9. And this active caspase 9 is the first caspase to be activated. What happens to the story later? I will continue the story in execution phase. So the same diagram from the Robbins you can see. Let me tell you the two membranes of the mitochondria. Between the two membranes, here is the cytochrome C. This is the gate of the mitochondria, known as mitochondrial transit. This is BCL2 BCLX closing the door. When DNA damage will occur, this BCL2 BCLX is replaced by BARC, BIM, BARC. So they will open the door. Once the door is opened, the cytochrome C is coming in the cytoplasm. After coming in the cytoplasm, see the pair, the best friends, which are the two best friends, procaspase 9 and APAF1. This purple color is APAF1. So the cytochrome C will take APAF1 with him. So procaspase 9 will become converted into active caspase 9 because he is alone. And what will happen to the story ahead, I will tell you. So this is the story written in the flowchart. So stimulus is coming from DNA. So BCL2, BCLX are lost. And these are replaced by BARC, BARC, BIM. So they will open the door, known as mitochondrial permeability. They will increase the permeability. So cytochrome C will come in the cytoplasm. So it will activate APAF1. So procaspase 9 will get activated into active caspase 9. So these are anti-apoptotic proteins which were closing the door. BCL2, BCLX, MCL, FLIP. They were closed the door. These were many MCQs come on it. And these are pro-apoptotic proteins. BARC, BARC, BIM, BARC, P53, APAF1, cytochrome. These are opening the door. So these are pro-apoptotic proteins. Done. So we are done with initiation phase of extrinsic pathway and initiation phase of intrinsic pathway. Where we have left the story, do intermission ho chuke hain. Now I will continue the story in third half, like Bahubali. Yes or no? So it is caspase 8 in the initiation phase. It is caspase 9 in the initiation phase. Activation of caspase 8 here, it is the initiation phase, end of initiation phase of extrinsic pathway. Activation of caspase 9 is end of initiation phase of intrinsic pathway. Now I am continuing the execution phase, which is common for both. So execution phase is the convergence point for intrinsic as well as extrinsic. Let's see. So here from extrinsic pathway, the caspase 8 is already activated. How you know the story? By death receptors. In intrinsic pathway, caspase 9 is already activated. How you know the story? It is via mitochondria cytochrome C. So these will activate two next caspase. Caspase 8 and caspase 9 will activate caspase 3 and 7. So 3 and 7 are the first caspase which are activated in execution pathway. So and after 3 and 7, all caspase will become activated and they will cleave the cell. Nucleus, cytoplasm, protein, cell membrane, everything will be cleaved and apoptotic bodies are formed. So all caspase will become activated either by intrinsic pathway or by extrinsic pathway. Ultimately all of them are activated. If you talk about intrinsic pathway, it is the caspase number 9 which become first activated. In extrinsic pathway, caspase number 8 first become activated. In execution pathway, 3 and 7, and then all of them will be activated and they will degrade the cell and convert the cell into multiple apoptotic bodies. Ultimately a phagocyte will come and engulf all the apoptotic bodies. No leakage, no inflammation. So caspase 8 and 9 are initiation caspase, 8 in the extrinsic pathway, 9 in the intrinsic pathway, and caspase 3 and 7 are execution caspase. Very important MCQ. So I am done with the mechanism. Let me talk about the last step, phagocytosis, in detail. Listen, how phagocytosis takes place. As I have told you, this is a phagocyte, the green colored cell. You can see here the green colored cell. the phagocyte is coming and engulfing all the apoptotic bodies. Now phagocyte, this is the phagocyte here. Phagocyte don't have eyes. So phagocyte will look, this is a normal cell, man, I don't have to eat this, and these are apoptotic bodies, I have to eat this. How phagocyte will recognize, I don't have to eat this cell and I have to eat this cell? Does anyone know? Phagocyte don't have the eyes, na? So how he will see and how he will recognize that this is a normal cell, I don't have to eat or engulf this cell. This is an apoptotic cell, I have to eat it. So there is a tagging on the cell. Listen. So what happens? This is a normal cell. This is a cell membrane of a normal cell. On the cell membrane, on the inner side, there is a phospholipid present, which is known as phosphatidyl serine. Phosphatidyl serine is present on the inner membrane. But during apoptosis, the cell membrane flip-flap. Ulat-pulat ho jata hai. Flip-flap occurs. So this phosphatidyl serine comes on the outer side, and phagocyte recognize this cell by phosphatidyl serine. So phagocyte will engulf only that cell which have phosphatidyl serine on the outer side. So phagocyte will engulf this cell. Phagocyte will not engulf this cell because phosphatidyl serine is present on the inner side. So it is the phosphatidyl serine which is causing tagging. It is externalization of phosphatidyl serine because of flip-flap of the cytoplasmic membrane. I hope you got it. So here also diagram from Robbins, you can see here normal cell membrane, you can see this is the cell membrane and this phosphatidyl serine is present on the inner side. And here during apoptosis, formation of apoptotic bodies, during flip-flap, this phosphatidyl serine is present on the outer side. So virtually inflammation is absent because there is no leakage. So I am done with definition, types, mechanism. Now, okay, morphology, I have to quit. Just a second. Okay, just a second. Give me a minute. So here I am done with it. Thank you very much.